Why Nana, what a giant nose you have. Why Pop Pop, what giant ears you have. Are there parts of your body that never stop growing? Hey there, irregular growths. Trace here for DNews. If today is your 21st birthday, then I've got some bad news for you. Have a drink. Chances are that if you're like most of the population, you have now stopped growing in the last few years. Maybe even in the last few months if you're a male, because females undergo puberty earlier and subsequently reach the end of their development a few years before males do. When I say development, I don't just mean puberty. I mean all the development you've gone through, starting as a single-celled zygote and ending around age 21. Now, to be clear, you don't actually stop growing. You probably have between 50 and 75 trillion cells in your body at any one time, and each of those has a limited lifespan and will almost certainly be replaced by a new cell. Of course, your hair and nails keep growing right up until you die. And by the way, your hair and nails don't continue growing after death, as is the popular urban legend. No, actually, your skin shrinks when you die thanks to dehydration, and it only looks like things are growing. Okay, so by now it sounds like you really do stop growing at the end of the puberty train, but what's the biggest difference between an adult man and an old man? Well, why don't you take a look at this picture? You might notice two, or I guess three, big differences. The schnoz and those two catcher's mitts, the nose and the ears. They are noticeably larger on older people. So do your nose and ears really keep growing forever? Would immortality mean that we all end up looking like a giant elephant person, trunk included? Well, the nose and the ears are made up of something called cartilage. Cartilage is a type of tissue, and your body has four different kinds: connective, epithelial, muscular, and nervous tissue. That covers pretty much everything from skin to the stuff between your bones and your muscles and nerves. Each kind of tissue is unique. Cartilage is called connective tissue, which is the most abundant kind in your body. That's because cartilage is basically like multi-purpose lubricant, glue and duct tape all in one. Cartilage can be worn down, stretch out, serve as padding for things like your ribs and the end of your bones and between your spinal vertebrae, as well as construct things outside of your body, specifically the nose and the ears, which are made up of elastic cartilage. And cartilage is special. It doesn't have blood vessels or nerves in it, which gives it some interesting properties. For one, when the tissue starts to break down and needs to repair itself, it can't. At least, not as easily or cleanly as the rest of your tissue. Instead, cartilage ends up healing by scarring. The formerly elastic structure ends up harder and thicker and droopier, especially as you age. It's not that cartilage keeps growing as you get older. It's that it breaks down, sags, drips, and noticeably enlarges when compared to the more repairable skin of your face, lips, eyes, and forehead. Those stay more or less tight while your ears and nose slowly but surely succumb to gravity. So yes, parts of the body do get larger in adulthood by comparison, like the ears and nose, and some parts never stop growing while you're alive, like your hair and your nails, but if it's your 21st birthday, then you're almost done developing. You're physically stuck this way. Well, for a while. Which makes sense from an evolutionary standpoint. After puberty, you're ready to make a baby. And once you're ready to make a baby, your genetic structure basically gives up on trying to make you better. You might even get smaller. Sorry, big nose shorties. But what if you want to build muscle mass? Are you actually growing that muscle? How does that work? Amy has the answer for you right here. So what are you the most afraid of in terms of aging? Let us know down in the comments. Make sure you come back here every day for more DNews. And please, subscribe.